The concepts behind heat and temperature and the differences between the two can sometimes be difficult to grasp. While the concept of temperature is universally known, most people get confused with actual heat transfer. This video is intended to introduce these topics that will be further explained and experienced by measuring heat and temperature in a series of educational workshops. Let's start with the basics. Most people are pretty familiar with temperature. It's simply a measure of how hot or cold something is. It represents a static value of energy in a material. In reality, it is the potential for heat to move from one material to another. We can measure it using various sensors like thermometers, RTDs, thermocouples, and many other devices that give the user a measurement in units of degrees. Heat flux, on the other hand, is the transfer of thermal energy measured in units of watts, or watts per area for heat flux. It occurs from a heat source to a heat sink. Consequently, heat transfer is related to temperature differences. But it's very different from the temperature. Let's go over a few common examples to illustrate. Let's say you're cooking a turkey at Thanksgiving. How long do you need to cook it in the oven? It clearly depends on the temperature of the oven and how big the turkey is. That's because it fundamentally is a matter of how much energy must be transferred to the turkey to sufficiently raise its temperature. How long it takes depends on how fast the heat transfer occurs. This is why a convection oven can cook faster than a simple radiant oven. The convection oven will provide more heat transfer at the same operating temperature than a radiation-only oven. Therefore, the turkey will cook faster. Another example is how you feel outside. Say you're sitting outside under a tree and the temperature is 65 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, take the tree away so that you're sitting under direct sunlight. The sunlight is a form of radiative heat flux, which can be felt by your body. You'll feel hotter in the direct sunlight than in the shade, even though the ambient temperature is the same for both. Now, let's introduce a breeze. This breeze acts as convective heat transfer that will pull heat away from your body and make you feel cooler. Once again, what you're feeling is the different heat fluxes from the sun, shade, or breeze, even though the temperature outside has not changed. This is all good information, but how do you measure heat? Everyone knows how to measure temperature, but few people know how to measure heat. Well, much like thermometers and thermocouples are sensors that measure temperature, heat flux sensors can measure heat flux directly. Several manufacturers around the world make different types of heat flux sensors. FluxTeq manufactures heat flux and temperature sensors that are particularly easy to use, as described in the following video.